Tennis has been blessed with many greats over its history, but we are living in a time where the three greatest players of all time played in the same era. I'm going to tell you who was the GOAT and why he is the GOAT. Please don't take anything personal. Everyone is free to form their own opinions, and you are all free to agree or disagree with me. Feel free to share your thoughts or comment down below. Now, some people like to think that whoever has the best statistics or the most Grand Slams is the greatest of all time. End of conversation. While I do believe Grand Slam titles carries the most weight for this argument, it is not the be-all and end-all. You have to look closely at the details, and when you do, you might be quite surprised at what you find. So here's the list ranking players in the Open era with the most Grand Slam major titles. As you can see, Roger Federer tops the list at number 1 with 20 Grand Slams to his resume. Followed closely behind is Rafael Nadal with 17. Pete Sampras sits at 3rd with 14, and Novak Djokovic is creeping up now with 13. While nothing is ever 100% guaranteed, let's just, for this argument's sake, say that Djokovic will tie or surpass Sampras at some point in the near future. So the top three will look like this: Federer, Nadal, Djokovic, in any order. But it's those three, the big three, who have dominated this era of tennis like no other era in tennis history has been dominated before. Take a look at this. Since 2004, the Grand Slams, the Australian Open, French Open, Wimbledon, and US Open, have been dominated by the big three. They have won 50 out of the last 60 Grand Slams. That's right, 50. That's a whopping 83% winning percentage. Only 5 players not named Roger, Rafa, and Novak have won a Grand Slam since 2004. That's almost 15 years, and only 5 people not named one of those big three have won. Of those 5 people, only 2 of them have won more than once. Wawrinka and Murray each have 3. So now you get the idea. 50 Grand Slams have been won and shared between Federer, Nadal, and Djokovic. 50 Grand Slams. But here's where it starts to get interesting. Of Roger's record-setting 20 Grand Slams, 15 of them were won before 2010. Since 2010 to the present day, he's only won 5 Grand Slams in the past 8 years. Now you might say, well, he's older now. Yes, he's 36, but if you subtract 8 from 36, he was well in his prime at 28 years old. He never had any serious injuries at that time that kept him out. So why has he only won 5 slams since? And don't forget, of those 5 slams that he has won between 2010 to 2018, 3 of them were actually won just recently in 2017 and 18, with his resurgence coming back from the 6-month layoff due to knee injury. So that means he actually only won 2 Grand Slams between 2010 to 2016, a 6-year span playing in his prime, and he only wins 2 slams. How can that be? Perhaps that's due to 2 reasons: Nadal and Djokovic. Before 2010, Nadal had 6 Grand Slams and Djokovic with only 1. Since 2010 to the present day 2018, Djokovic leads with 12 slams, Nadal with 11, and Federer with only 5. Now Roger's 5 years older than Nadal, 6 years older than Djokovic. So naturally this would mean that Roger had turned pro much earlier than Nadal or Djokovic and played the first half of his prime years without having to really deal with a prime Nadal or Djokovic who were young and still finding their footing. With all due respect to the level of the opponents Roger's had to face in his Grand Slams, names such as Philippoussis, Safin, Andy Roddick 4 times, Hewitt, Agassi at the end of his career, Fernando Gonzalez, Soderling, you name, etc. But he had only faced a young Djokovic once and a young Nadal 7 times in Grand Slam finals matches before 2010. Roger had a record of 2-5 head-to-head versus Nadal. Remember, this is the Federer era of his 15 slams, and Nadal was now taking over the head-to-head with Federer. This is where the greatest rivalry was formed in Federer vs. Nadal, better known as Fedal. Then enter 2010, the so-called Djokovic era, where he leads 12-11 in slams over Nadal, and they are 4-4 tied in head-to-head in Grand Slam final matches. Now the greatest rivalry has shifted over to Djokovic-Nadal. Head-to-head, Djokovic leads Nadal 27-25. He also leads Federer 23-22, and Nadal leads Federer head-to-head 23-15. What am I getting at here? Take a closer look once more at this chart that shows dominance. You can see from around 2004 to 2008, Federer was dominant. And then for a couple of years in 2009 and 2010, Nadal ascends and surpasses Federer. But then you can see the Djokovic era of dominance from 11 to 15. A little blip in the chart with Murray in 16, and then Nadal retaking dominance from 17 and 18 currently at the world number one position. Of course, mind you, Djokovic has been dealing with injuries, but injuries is no stranger to Nadal as well, and that can be another debate. Federer has also had a resurgence, which is undoubtedly impressive and surprising for most of us because he went 4 years without winning a Grand Slam, and it really didn't look like he was ever going to win another one, and his ranking had even dropped to well outside top 10. But here's my point. Rafael Nadal, of the three, had his entire career sandwiched between two of arguably the greatest tennis players of all time. The start of his career had to face and deal with a prime Roger Federer, who dominated the first half of his career. And yet, Nadal still somehow amassed 6 slams in the so-called Federer era, and he edged Roger Federer 5-2 in head-to-head Grand Slam matches. And he also overtook Roger Federer in the overall head-to-head record. And just when you think it's going to be all Rafa from that point on, 2010 onwards comes Djokovic and his prime. He dominates the next few years to establish his kingdom and era in tennis, and yet somehow Rafa amasses another 11 slams of his own? If we are just talking about statistics and whoever has the most slams, then if Djokovic didn't have Nadal in his way, he'd have 20 by now. And if Nadal didn't have Djokovic in his way, he'd have about 23 by now. They sort of canceled each other out because they stole slams from each other back and forth in their epic 5-set down-to-the-wire battles. During this 4-year Grand Slam drought for Federer, Nadal and Djokovic were killing each other and getting in each other's way of amassing slams to surpass Federer. I want to conclude and say this. Growing up, you know, I was a Federer fan first. He was my favorite player. I started to hate this kid named Nadal because he started to beat Roger all the time and I wanted Roger to keep piling up slams. But then later on, I became enamored with Nadal because a newer and bigger foe appeared on the scene in Djokovic, who started to win everything, and now I was rooting for Nadal. Roger at that point had been somewhat out of the picture and a non-threat to Djokovic. I mean, Djokovic had beaten him in 3 straight slams, so it looked like at that point Roger was on his way out. So I started to hate this guy Novak because he seemed to be doing to Nadal what Nadal had done to Roger. But at the same time, Nadal was still in his prime. This is still his time to win, but Novak looked like he was edging him out. Both Roger and Rafa had dominating winning records against Novak head to head until, of course, he hit his prime, and then he pretty much took over and took the head-to-head lead on both Nadal and Roger. The reason why I think Nadal is the greatest of all time is because Djokovic is probably the real GOAT, but will never get that recognition. If it wasn't for Nadal, Djokovic's era would still continue, and he'd be well on his way to amassing over 20 slams, and vice versa. If Djokovic hadn't arrived on the scene at the time of Nadal's ascension, he easily would have been over 20 slams by now, probably around 23 or 24. So the fact that the pre-2010 Federer was number one, Nadal number two, and then the post-2010 Djokovic was one, and Nadal number two, Nadal has had to battle through 2 reigns of two of the greatest players of all time, and yet he has somehow amassed 17 slams, more than Djokovic and only 3 behind Roger, with 5 years more youth on Roger. If you think about it, it is understandable why Roger may always sit atop the rankings with the most slams, but the fact that Nadal is even this close to Roger is a true testament to how good he really is, something that stats on paper won't really be able to tell you. So that's my opinion. Let me know what you think down below. Feel free to comment. Like and subscribe if you liked the video, and until next time.